Recently, the Y-Files came up with some surprisingly fair evaluations in a show that covered the Electric Universe model of cosmology. While I agree with the duo that we do get a lot of the science right, there were a couple things that could have used a little more research. For now, I'm going to set the record straight on a few of Wal Thornhill's predictions about Comet Temple 1. Now, Y-Files claimed that Wal made a lot of predictions, and of them, almost none came true. Now, his followers like to talk about the ones he does get right, but AJ couldn't think of any off the top of his head. I took a look at the University of Maryland's Deep Impact mission papers and found what they predicted was going to happen at Temple 1. And I quote, "There is a plan for a comet mission called Deep Impact, scheduled for July 2005. Deep Impact spacecraft will arrive at Comet Temple 1 and become the first mission to impact the surface of a comet. A 350-kilogram or 770-pound copper mass impactor will create a spectacular football field-sized crater, 7 stories deep, on a comet approximately 4 miles in diameter. This is the first attempt to peer beneath the surface of a comet to its freshly exposed material for clues to the early formation of the solar system." End quote. Okay, so, small explosion, giant crater, and lots of primordial ice to eject from the impact and get analyzed by the instruments on board the spacecraft. Here's what Wal Thornhill said was going to happen back on October 2001, a full 3.5 years before the mission. Quote, "The electrical model suggests the likelihood of an electrical discharge between the comet nucleus and the copper projectile, particularly if the comet is actively flaring at the time. The projectile will approach too quickly for a slow electrical discharge to occur, so the energetic effects of the encounter should exceed that of a simple physical impact, in the same way that was seen with Comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 at Jupiter. Changes to the appearance of the jets may be seen before impact. The signature of an electrical discharge would be a high-energy burst of electrical noise across a wide spectrum, a flash from infrared to ultraviolet, and the enhanced emission of X-rays from the vicinity of the projectile. The energy of a mechanical impact is not sufficient." Unquote. And here he is again in 2005, just one day before the impact. Quote, "Temple 1 has a low eccentricity orbit. Therefore, its charge imbalance with respect to its environment at perihelion is low. It is a low-voltage comet. Electrical interactions with Deep Impact may be slight, but they should be measurable if NASA will look for them. They would likely be similar to those of Comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 prior to striking Jupiter's atmosphere. The most obvious would be a flash, lightning-like discharge, shortly before impact." Unquote. And here's what actually happened in the words of Deep Impact's co-investigator Peter Schultz describing the event recorded from the spacecraft on the 4th of July in 2005. Quote, "What you see is really surprising. First there's a small flash, then there's a delay. Then there's a big flash and the whole thing breaks loose." End quote. "First thing seen, an intensely bright two-part flash that overwhelms the optical sensors, just like Wal said. Note Peter's surprise. This was neither predicted nor expected by the so-called experts. Score 1 for the EU model." Next, Wal goes on to say, and I quote, "Electrical stress may short out the electronics on board the impactor before impact." Unquote. The last few seconds of the copper impactor's life sent back no pictures. It was supposed to, but it didn't. Now, can we prove something shorted out due to the high voltage electrical discharge Wal predicted? Maybe not. But the electrical system did fail and stop transmitting information just as the first bright flash erupted. Granted, it was difficult to see what was going on right up close, considering the huge energetic flash the experts did not predict and cannot explain. So I guess you can draw your own conclusions about whether a lightning bolt was involved. Hey AJ and Hecklefish, take a look at NASA's animation of what they thought was going to happen. You'll note some dark shrapnel flying out of a giant football-sized crater. Super wrong. There was barely a crater at all. Why? Because what the experts thought was a fluffy ball of ice and dust was actually just like any other asteroid or comet. It was a rock, just like Wal said it would be. But hey, everyone makes mistakes. Emmanuel Velikovsky, as a pioneer, made some mistakes. And according to our critics, that should disqualify the whole theory. Weird how that logic never seems to go both ways. But no matter how hard you smash a copper coffee can into a rock, it turns out water just isn't coming out of it. I guess that's why we only discovered 1% of the water experts predicted. Wall's prediction on deep impact was accurate because he understood the principles of electricity can work in outer space. Knowing that, it doesn't take a crystal ball to figure out what will happen when you fire a copper conductor into a solid wall of ionized rock. I know, there's lots of really smart people with degrees who all believe in black holes and dark matter and pulsars that spin 4 times faster than helicopter blades before changing direction. Then again, big archaeology was full of learned people with prestigious degrees who all claimed without any hesitation or doubt that human civilization was at most 8,000 years old. And then we found Göbekli Tepe, and realized that all those prestigious experts with their degrees were not only wrong, they were super wrong. So there it is. If predictive success is a measure of a model's viability, which it surely is, can we aim the term pseudoscience where it belongs? Even if you want to claim Wall was off on some predictions, you should ask yourself, compared to whom? Because if this is a contest, one thing is clear. The Standard Model of Cosmology is often surprised by observations, whereas the EU model is typically validated by them. And that should tell you everything you need to know to make up your own mind.